Hey y'all, welcome to another Paint Your Truth process painting session. This particular video will be different from the other videos because I just felt in the spirit of painting, self-care, wellness. I just jumped into it and you'll see it within the video that I didn't do a lot of talking, but just a lot of like painting. And of course I fast forward the speed of things. So this will be a prequel to the actual video, so bear with me. But per usual, before we get into anything and everything, let's clear out the room and then we'll jump into some things. So I have my sage already ready. Let me just light it up. Hopefully y'all are having a fantastic Friday. Today is Friday
25th,
I believe, of February. A lot of things going on in the world, a lot of energies, a lot of dystopianism, if you want to be quite clear. But we're going to clear off this space of any negativity, any doubt, any hesitation, any frustration, any imposter syndrome, anything that doesn't serve us, anything that does not allow us to be in our highest vibration. Let us be present. Let us be focused on our mental health, our wellness, our mind, body, and soul, and everything that is for our best benefit. Ashe, ashe. Okay, let's do three taps from the same bowl. We will inhale and exhale with each tap. All right, let's just set that aside. And we're gonna do one spray with the lavender spray. As you know, if you are a returner to this channel, when I use lavender spray, it is meant to ground me, to be present, and for me to be in the peace of body, peace of mind, and peace at soul. So one spritz, inhale, exhale. And it's all natural, all organic essential spray, so it's no biggie. Now, so as you can see, the canvas is already completed, so there's nothing that I actually have to add on. Maybe if you know me, I might add some gold glitter because that's my thing, but for the most part, it is completed. Now, if you are a first-time watcher of Paint Your Truth, Paint Your Truth is process painting. What is process painting? Process painting is different from any like paint night or art class. When it comes to process painting, it is asking the painter, whether you are a beginner, professional, whatever level you are, even if it's just crayons and just filling in the lines, not coloring outside the lines, whatever it is, coloring book and all, it is the process of the artist, the person, the client, focusing on what makes them feel better, what makes them feel whole. Process painting is very intentional about what you paint, how you paint it, and being aware of the process, how you feel in the moment. When it comes to process painting, there is no mode of practice, meaning that you can use any medium, you can use any source. I use paint, hence Paint Your Truth, but you don't have to go about it just like any other person who is in the shared space. You don't have to paint the same. You don't have to use the same colors. You don't even have to use the same stroke method. It is about what helps you become more whole and what helps you reach your mental health goals. With Paint Your Truth, what we focus on is, what do you need to help your mental health become better? How do you feel as you are painting? And then what did you learn about yourself through the process? Now, because Paint Your Truth focuses on mental health, the purpose of the clients coming to Paint Your Truth is to be aware of what helps them make their mental health the best. Meaning, how do we get back into our mental health? How do we get back into focus? How do we get back into intentional being? And for this particular canvas, I was using the Sacred Self-Care Oracle deck. I use these when I do readings. And as you, if you are new to this channel, you might not know, but if you are a returner, you know I also do tarot readings on this particular channel. So it's an artistic bundle of sorts. And the particular card that I have within these, I think it's 48 or 52 card deck, bottom of the deck. Number 21, drink tea. So this was my interpretation of this particular card, because I am always drinking tea and I'm always meditating and I'm always present in how I feel in my own body, which makes me aware of how other people feel in their body. A lot of times we're ripping and running. We don't know how we feel. We might be like, oh, we're a little topsy-turvy, but we've been feeling this way for a very long time. So it might be anxiousness. How do we mediate that anxiousness, right? Or someone else, you might think that they're standoffish, but really they might be going through depression. So being able to accurately put labels on what you're feeling helps you get the help that you need. And it also helps you help other people, so you're not miscommunicating, but also you're not just flippantly creating biases where you're thinking the person is this way when in actuality it's something deeper than that. So that is that. And when it comes to process painting, I provide all the supplies. When it comes to Paint Your Truth, this is the canvases, the easels, the paint brushes, even the paint palettes. The only thing I require of participants is to be open to the process. It is a shared space. We can do one-on-one sessions or we can do a group session, but regardless to what, it is an experience that is shared, but it is personalized because no two canvases look the same. Even with all the arrays of color, it does not matter. I have yet to have seen two participants draw the same exact image. So I think that is that. I think I have everything covered. And when it does come to the paints, let me show you. Obviously, this is a paint palette that has been used by me. But when it comes to the paints, I do advise people to just use a penny amount. It seems small, but trust and believe me, it is usually the right amount. And the great thing about painting is when you run out of colors, you can always put more colors in. So you're never not able to achieve what you're trying to ultimately make. And side note, when you use too much paint and you think you need to fill it to the rim, you end up with excess paint, and excess paint ends up drying and ends up being a waste. So, and if you are in the Massachusetts area and this is something that you would be enthusiastic about, you can definitely reach out to me via email at paintyourtruth.art@gmail.com. You can also find me on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Tumblr, and email, Paint Your Truth. On Instagram, it is paintyourtruth_. Don't forget the underscore, and everything, just like every other YouTuber, will be down in the description box below. So, let's just jump right into the video. So as you can see, I am outlining the particular oracle card, meditation number 21, and I'm just taking my time. I'm not trying to make it absolutely exactly the same because it's my interpretation, and just like I said beforehand in the prequel of this video, is that no two pieces look the same, even if there is a particular model that we are fashioning our canvases off of. They will not look the same because we are not the same people. We don't have the same stroke, as well as this is not a test and this is not an art class. This is just for us to get into what makes us feel whole, what grounds us in our own wellness and self-care. And speaking of wellness and self-care, I actually went to this, I don't want to say an amusement park because it wasn't nothing like Six Flags or like Disneyland, but it was so awesome. It's called Ice Castle. They have a few locations, one in Vermont, one in New Hampshire, I think one in Idaho, and maybe two places, other locations. But I went to the one in New Hampshire with my friend and her sisters,
And it was such a good time. Like, I was out there throwing snowballs like I was a little last kid. And it's just those type of small things, those type of like spontaneities, as well as like child carefreeness, that I feel like a lot of us, especially when we become adults, we're adulting, you know, we're getting that money so we can pay bills. We just forget what life's spark is. As children, I feel like they are made out of like glitter, not actual glitter like what I use on my canvases, but glitter in a sense of like spark and inspiration and motivation and happiness. Like, they always see the brighter things in life. And then as we get older, because we have some life experiences and sometimes they aren't that great, you know, they bruise us up, we have a few ego deaths, we have a couple of setbacks, we start diminishing our own sparkle, our own glitter of life. We start to be a lot more cynical or less optimistic. And at the ice castle, it was mostly kids. I did call beforehand and was like, look, is this mostly for kids? Like, you come here with your kids, or can adults come in and have fun too? They said it was an equal amount of both, but later throughout the day, you saw it was mostly kids. But in the beginning part, it was cool because it was also adults there, you know, adults of multiple ages. And it literally looked like an ice castle. It looked like something out of Disney. And it was real ice, real snow. And you could see the different, I don't want to say monuments, but like sculptures. You could see the different design patterns. There were also activities to do like tubing. I'm not a sporty person by any stretch of the imagination, but I have a really good arm. I can throw. I'm good at that. And we went tubing. We also went around the actual ice castle, which was really nice. It was lit up very whimsical. It gave you all that Disney magical kid enthusiastic viewpoint, as well as we ended up playing, besides snowball, we ended up playing hide and seek. And it was a little bit difficult because by the time that we started, you know, really getting into like, let's just do sports activities, the sun was starting to set and then there was a lot more children there. We couldn't run around the way that we wanted to, which was fine because it was kind of slippery because the snow was melting. And then on top of that, there was kids and I didn't want to trample over no kids or anything like that. So we ended up playing something kind of like hide and seek, where it's more so, yeah, you count, yeah, you hide. But if there's like eye contact, that counts as like someone actually physically touched you. Because again, we don't want to knock anybody over. And we don't want to get kicked out the park, okay? I don't want my big grown age being kicked out of the park because I don't know how to act. But it was fun. There was one point that I didn't like. I was hiding in this awesome, awesome spot. And it was kind of like a box, but it was lower leveled. So like on the outside, it just looks like an open rectangle. If you're into gardening, it would be like a crate or something. You wouldn't be able to tell from the outside. But if you actually peeked in, you'd see like, oh, there's something deeper in there. So I found this awesome spot. Like, it's one of those things, if you think to look, then you'll find it. But if you don't think to look, it's just a part of the landscape. So I'm hiding. And then out of nowhere, there's kids, there's adults talking about, are you okay? Do you need help? And I'm like, I'm hiding. I'm fine. Please go. And it was just like, I became one of the park's entertainment sectors. Like, they would not leave me alone. And I was just like, I'm trying to hide. Like, I'm playing a game. Can you just go? And out of nowhere, this white woman pulls out her phone like she's about to record me without even my permission. And then the person who was supposed to get me got me because of all the attraction. And I was just looking at this woman. You cannot record me. I did not ask you to record me. Matter of fact, I told you to get. I told you to leave. I told you to shoo. And here you are, disrespecting my boundaries. So after that round of tag, I was kind of fed up. I was kind of annoyed. And then on top of that, there was more kids, obviously, as you can tell with my little rant. So we stopped and then we just enjoyed like how the lights looked when it got darker, because once it got darker, you could really see the illumination from the lights and the different colors and how they twinkle in the dark. And it gave you that whole outdoorsy firewood in nature type of tease with illumination. So we had a lot of pictures taken with a lot of fun. And I don't know if we would go back again. One of my friends actually wanted to come and she didn't have a chance to come. She had other prior affairs, but we might go again just for all three of us to have that experience. It was good for what it was worth. It wasn't too expensive. And then after that, we went to this Mexican restaurant. And I'm not gonna hold you, I didn't see no Mexicans or South Americans in the restaurant. So I was like, and we was in New Hampshire. New Hampshire's pretty Caucasian. So we were there and I was just like, oh, okay, this is a Mexican restaurant with no Mexicans. So who's cooking the food? And then my friend's sister was just laughing her ass off, like, you know you fall for that. And I was just like, I'm not. I'm just asking questions, because if I'm going to an authentic place, I'm assuming it's authentic from the ground up. So if I don't see nothing that looks authentic besides the cactuses and that Mexican flavor with the art and the wall paint, I'm just going to assume this is as authentic as Taco Bell. But to my surprise, it was actually really, really good and really, really authentic. So that was fun. And we ended up driving back. The whole trip in and of itself was about 4 or 5 hours. We got there at 2 and I got back home around like 8-ish. I got dropped off. So calculation, we spent a good amount of time there. And we left super early too because we didn't know the traffic. The last time I went to New Hampshire, I went to Hampton Beach, I believe. And I swear to God, it took us like 3-4 hours to go there and back. But then again, I don't know what day we left, but it was in the summer. I don't remember what day we left, but it was the summer. So there was just a lot of traffic. It was a beautiful beach, don't get me wrong, but it was a lot of traffic, annoying traffic. When we went to Ice Castle Island, different folks, different atmosphere, but I'm telling you how different and how less time consuming it was compared to both trips. When we went to Ice Castle, it wasn't as annoying and it wasn't as daunting, the drive, though I wasn't driving. But compared to how much traffic it could have been, it was an easy, smooth ride back and forth. Back returning, there was a little bit of traffic, but it wasn't as strenuous as like literally an hour to an hour and a half is just traffic. So that was nice. We ended up going before we landed in Ice Castle. We made a pit stop at this authentic chocolate place, like a chocolate shop in New Hampshire. I'm not gonna hold you, I do not remember that shop. If I do, I'll just add it to this video. But it was nice for what it's worth. The candy was good. I'm not gonna lie, as I get older, the less of a sweet tooth that I have. As a kid, I feel like all you can eat is Skittles, Starburst, M&M's, Hershey's, Nerds, the actual little candy thingies. Like, I feel like as a kid, you can eat them like for lunch, breakfast, dinner. You just eat them all day. As you get older, at least for me and the people that I know who really be adulting, it's like candy's cool, but like, I'd rather have a plate of like authentic and like good food. Hit me up with some good food. Candy's nice, but I need some like real food, not even no fast food, like some real, I put my heart in it type of food. So as I get older, I don't have the sweet tooth that I used to. And then on top of that, I do care about my health. I'm very health conscious. I'm gonna be honest with you, I could eat cleaner. I feel like we all could eat cleaner, but I don't harp on it. But I know I eat better, because beforehand I could not even tell you what vegetable, what fruit that I had within the week. Now I can tell you exactly what I get, exactly what I buy from the grocery store, if it is prepackaged or if I cooked it myself, how many fruits and vegetables I get. I'm very conscious about that because I do pack my food with fruits and vegetables. Well, maybe not fruits, but I do pack it with vegetables and I do get fruits. If I'm not going to eat fruits, because I'm kind of picky eater in the end of itself, I'm kind of picky. But if I'm not going to get, like, let's say mangoes and apples and pears, then I will get a smoothie. And a smoothie like a Naked, the brand, or Boathouse, the brand. And I'll use that as a way to leverage. But ultimately, I eat very well. I'm very conscious about what I eat and how much of it I do eat. And I do meal prep. So all of that has helped me lose a lot of weight. And baby girl has been trying to lose this weight since baby girl was a baby girl, okay? So I have lost a lot of weight due to the pandemic. On top of that, side note, because of the pandemic, I was a lot more conscious about, like, I need to get healthier. Again, I've always maintained a somewhat decent weight, but I could have done better. But now, like, I don't have the baby fat that I used to. So combination of growing up and a combination of the pandemic, and of course the beginning of the pandemic, no one really knew what was what. But the point was, if you had a healthy diet and you were taking care of yourself and you were drinking your water, social distancing, and all that good stuff, then you had a better chance of not getting the big COVID. And if you did get the big C, then you were able to recover faster and better. So because of all of that kind of like star-crossed, not lovers, but like everything was intersecting at the same time, it just gave me the oomph that I needed to really take care of myself. It's also quite funny because the friends that I have now are not the friends that I had before the pandemic. And one of my friends, well, both of my friends actually, are like, how do you maintain such a like smaller figure? Like, how are you like this? And I'm like, I used to be a whole lot bigger. Like, I've been a bigger girl all my life. This is like the first time in my life that I've been a smaller person, smaller weight, smaller waist. Okay. Just smaller everything. And they don't believe me. And interestingly enough, now that I picked a picture from the past and a most recent picture that we were all together at the same event, I'm going to text that to them to see their reaction, because they don't believe that I used to be a bigger girl because they can't see it. And it's interesting because the people who knew me before my transformation, if they saw me, they would be baffled too. Baffled at different spectrums of the spectrum, I guess you could say. People who knew me when I was a big girl would be flabbergasted because they're like, oh my God, what happened to the weight? And people who know me now can't vision me as a bigger person. So I'm gonna send them that picture after I'm done editing this video. And now that the pandemic is not as big and daunting, but it's still a thing. Like, don't get it twisted. People still out here, you know, getting the COVID, going to hospitals. Like, it's still a thing. Don't believe the CDC. Don't believe the hype. Like, they got their own agenda. So still wear your mask, still social distance, still get the hand sanitizer, still do what you need to do. But because of setting that tone of taking care of myself, taking care of my body, I have been able to maintain it, not even as a chore or like, oh, because I don't want to get COVID, as opposed to like, this is just a routine of things now. So baby girl has lost a lot of weight, and baby girl has been able to maintain just a healthier and well-balanced just existence on top of my mental health, because that has been something that has always been not so secure, but I haven't been able to make it, such as doing such things as process painting, tarot and meditation, astrology, speaking my truth, being very honest with myself, and not protecting other people's feelings and internally drowning. That's something that I had a really hard time growing up, having the space and grace to speak my truth, to stand in my authenticity and like set boundaries. And that has affected me a lot. So as I got older, I learned that it's okay to speak my truth, even if it's offensive, because what I am saying is not offensive. Someone may not have the emotional maturity to handle what I'm saying, but I need to say it. And me saying it doesn't make me a bad person, doesn't make me anything other than a human being with their own opinion. I'm not about to be gaslighted and manipulated to accepting bullshit because someone else cannot handle the responsibility of a critique. So with all that being said, I just became a more well-balanced, a healthier person, more affirmed in who I am, confident, well-balanced, healthy, and all that jazz. So I think I talked a lot in the voiceover part, and I'm gonna allow y'all to continue to see how this canvas ends up finished look-wise. So here we go. as you can see, this is the final canvas. So I got to take it from different angles, like we taking selfies. So hopefully y'all can see the resemblance, but it's obviously not exactly the same. That was not my goal. It was my own interpretation. And yeah, this is how it ultimately looks like. Dream big. And hopefully y'all, you know, see what I have done and implemented into your own lives, whether it is process painting or whatever form of meditation, wellness, self-care looks like to you. And of course, if you would like to have your own painting session with me, Paint Your Truth, all that information will be down below.
Have you ever done it?
Mouth.
No. So it looks like a fish. In the summer, there's sand sculpting.
A sea bass. How do you know it's a fish? I don't know. What's the state fish of New Hampshire?
Girl, maybe cod?
No. It's sure ain't no catfish.
No, because this is no wingless. It's probably like cod.
It's wingless.
Or bass?
It's a wingless owl.
Wingless owl. I like this. I like your art interpretation.
Yeah, look at his wings.
I see it. Those are the ears. Yeah. I see it. I see it. That's a moose.
Yeah.
That's the moose that you see with your eyes.
Yeah. His wing is right there.
This is a disabled owl. It's okay. We are all inclusionary here. Yeah. This is a disabled owl. The lights are nice though.
What?
This is kind of beautiful. It kind of looks like fireflies.
Have you ever seen them in real life?
It's amazing. It is.
Danger. It's just to protect. So Taurus the bull is there.
Astrologer.
You're the season where I was really into it.
No, this is on hold.
No, we're gonna go search for it together.
And with all that being said, y'all, be blessed, be enlightened, be loved. I shall see you on the next process painting session with Paint Your Truth, and I am out.